We have a quick update on the status of the detention of blogger Milos Wong, who was arrested on Sunday. And based on information received from his lawyers, he was remanded yesterday for 2 days. The police actually applied for 4 days. Today we are able to share with you information on the basis of his arrest and detention obtained directly from the lawyers. And now we know that apparently the purported basis of his arrest is, or rather the offense that he's committed is connected to this article which is written in his blog entitled Maklumat Sulit Pendatang Asing Bakal Cetus Huru-Hara di Sabah. That basically means secret information will foreigners create disturbances in Sabah? As a question, he's posing it as a question. The article, his article, refers to an email from a source who claims to be an internal source in the police force, and that a document, an official-looking document is enclosed, which talks about 1,400 foreigners assembling in Kota Kinabalu and Tawau, apparently to create disturbances. And it alerts, the official document calls upon police officers and security personnel to be alert on the highest level to deal with this situation. And Milos Wong also points out that apparently this email has gone out to in a chain email form, so many people have received it. He's not the only one. But he cautions people to say, well, the authenticity of the documents has not been verified, so read it and understand it in that context. So, Pakatarai wants to ask the police today and the authorities who are pushing this arrest and detention, what's wrong with this article? The contents are obviously a matter of public interest. Milos Wong was discharging his duty as a journalist, as a blogger, to write about it. And he wrote about it quite professionally. So now, based on what we're told by his lawyers, the police now allege that this is a breach of the Official Secrets Act. So, by saying that, other police now say that this document is a real document, it's a valid document. And they claim it to be an official secret. And they are saying by Milos Wong writing about it, he has breached the Official Secrets Act. So my question to the police force and to the authorities, especially UMNO, Barisan Nasional, nationalists, if this was a real document, then why are you keeping quiet about it? Surely you should have discussed this with the public of Malaysia, the people of Malaysia. You're claiming that there's a basis to say that 1,400 foreigners are assembled in Kota Kinabalu, in Tawau, planning to do disturbances and waiting for weapons from the Philippines. That's what the document says. And this information is not shared with the public. So, as far as we are concerned, it raises a real question mark as whether this document is a real document in the first place, as Milos Wong himself correctly pointed out. And it raises a question as to what is the real motive behind his arrest and detention by using this article and this document. It looks to me that basically Milos Wong is being punished, and especially close to the elections, for writing as a supporter of Pakatan. He doesn't, I think people know his sympathies, his political sympathies. He's a blogger, a very popular blogger, and he's known to be a supporter of Pakatan Raya. And is his arrest and detention today an attempt to silence him, keep him in detention until the elections are over? For me, it's pretty obvious now that is what the intention of this arrest and detention is. It's a malafide arrest and detention with political motives, with improper, evil political motives, to silence a blogger who is writing in favor of us. And this is why Pakatarai is very clear about this aspect of media freedom. The laws like the Official Secrets Act have been regularly abused to restrict media freedom, and Milos Wong's arrest and detention is another recent example of this, the most recent example. Pakatarai remains committed to repeal of this law, and we will replace it with the Freedom of Information Act. To this is the proper, this is what the people of Malaysia deserve, not oppressive and abusive use of these draconian laws as what we're seeing now with Miloswam. Just a final point, we also understand that today as we speak, there's an application in court to remand him further, to detain him further. And apparently the basis that will be used is other police reports. And we understand that those other police reports will most likely be the reports lodged by the SPR or the Election Commission against Miloswam, based on his comments on the language used by the SPR about the term Undi Awal and Undi Post, you know, the postal vote and the early voting system. The SPR apparently took offense to what he wrote and lodged a police report. And as far as Pakatan is concerned, this is an abuse of power by the SPR. If they feel that he's misunderstood it or got it wrong, then you just correct him, you just write a response and say, Mr. Miloswam, you obviously haven't understood what we are saying, or you don't understand the technique of the terms. This is what it means and this is what it means. Instead of just doing that, you lodge a police report, which is now being abused by the police and we believe on instructions to detain him further and try to silence him and keep him behind bars until election day. So we condemn this arrest and detention unreservedly. We call for his immediate release. The police should stop this sort of harassment of bloggers and not take political instructions and abuse their powers. Assuming, as your question suggests, assuming it is a real valid document, then I think the authorities have been totally irresponsible for not bringing this up to the attention of the Malaysian public. Totally irresponsible. This is not what a responsible government does. If it was real, we needed to know about it, and we needed to know what the Malaysian government is going to do about it. Nothing like that has happened. So I'm more inclined to say now that actually there's no real basis to this in the first place, and this is just being used to as a as a false basis to arrest and detain.
Article talks about this 1,400 people. Is it in relation to the Sulu incursion,
We don't know. I think these are questions you should ask Minister Hishamuddin. He's the guy who should be held accountable for this piece of news.
So there's no date about when they were supposed to create chaos.
It's a very vague document, like I'm saying. It's very vague. It's really, but this is a question we should put to the minister and say, what are you doing about this, assuming it's real? Because by arresting and detaining Miloswam, you are saying this is real. This Borang Utusan is a real document. Because you are saying he is released. He's breached the Official Secrets Act and released this document. So then, if this is real, what is this minister doing about it? I think that he has to answer. I can't answer that. No, that's very clear. In the police application for remand, they are asserting to the court that this is the basis of his arrest and detention. This is the offence for which he was arrested. An offence for breach of the Official Secrets Act. I mean, you can't arrest you must assert a criminal offence before you arrest and detain. And this is the police position, this is their position.
The police released
a statement saying
that he was actually arrested for having posted something about early voting, which I'm not very sure of, I just remember seeing it. But, you are saying today that he was actually arrested because
So, just to confirm what you are saying, you said the police issued a written statement saying that, and that was released yesterday.
The police issued a statement.
Alright, okay. Now, my response is, if the police have issued that statement, then that statement is of a misrepresentation. Yeah. Because what they have told the court when they made the remand application yesterday morning is something completely different. Completely different. So that makes it even worse that the police don't even know why they arrested him, or now are creating another reason for arresting him.
You say they're changing their reasons.
They're changing their reasons, yes. So I can just confirm to you now what they told the court, and that's a a serious position because you make representations to the court. This is why you're arresting the person and why you want to hold him. Yeah.